You know, when reading the script, do you get scared at all, or do you? Is it only when you watch the stuff?
When reading it.
Yeah.
No.
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 Yeah, like if you read Stephen King or something like that, you might get scared. But does it translate to a script?
It was more shock for me. It wasn't. Yeah. It wasn't a. Boo. Kind of
I always actually struggle to get involved reading a script, even if it's a good one, just because of the format. The way it's written, there's so many things that are making you realize that you're reading something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Whereas the book, you can just kind of get lost in it. You're like, oh, exterior, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's spooky. Yeah.
Cut to, oh, they're going to do it like that. Okay.
But was there a point that you thought, okay, this is what I want to do? Was it the twist? Or
it was the twist.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It was a visceral reaction to the twist.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like a kind of,
I guffawed.
I honestly do think I threw the script across the room, and that was mine. Yeah. And I just was like, I have to go pick it up, so I have to read what happens after that.
Well, no, you keep flipping the page, and like, what is wrong with Esther? And
you're like, what's wrong with me?
That I can't that understand I can't, what's wrong
that
with
I
Esther.
I have to keep reading this to figure out what the hell's going on. I mean, that's the thing about it. It was just, you know, it's unusual for that to come across.
The orphanage you thought she came from has never heard of her. Everything about her could be a lie. Everything.
Well, you have her passport, her birth certificate, school records, medical records.
These are papers from halfway around the world.
What is this? It's a piece of paper.
Your own mother was there this time. It wasn't just me. Your mother was there. It's either Esther or Daniel who started the fire. Who do you think it was?
I don't know.
I'm so done. I'm done connecting these dots for you. You know what? You can think whatever you want about me. I will leave tonight. If that's what you want, I will leave tonight on one condition. Esther goes too.
But your characters are interesting as well. I mean, it's not the usual shallow, surface-level stuff we normally see in horror films.
Right, right.
No, and I had a good dancing partner, who sort of committed to...
Yeah.
To whatever.
That means act together.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, it's not a horror movie that has... Yeah, we don't have the, like, whenever two people have sex in a horror movie, usually that means one of them's about to die, right? Normally, in horror movie language.
Yeah.
We don't... What I like about it is it doesn't have those kinds of horror movie tropes happening in it at all.
And tricks.
And, there's scary things that happen in it all over the place, but they seem more earned to me.
And what's really horrifying is that it's happening to real people with real problems.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what's so horrifying.
It's a certain class of people, too. You know, like, I remember when I first saw what our house looked like and what kind of car we drove, and I looked at the clothes I was wearing, I went like, right. Like, there's something about... we're a certain class of people that it's only... Not one that I grew up with, actually. Mm. Something I've only become aware of recently. It's like people have really interesting aesthetic taste and a good amount of money.
Mm-hmm.
Like, interesting books. I remember picking the books off the shelf and being like, ooh, these people have cool books.
Mm.
And like, they're cool. They're like hip people that are rich.
Mm-hmm.
I think they had to have a house big enough so they could be stalked within the house. I think that's one of the...
Oh, is that what it is?
So you have to have a certain level of money to...
Oh, is that
yeah. And it's like a house I designed.